Okay. So with that, I'd like to turn this over to Tony.
I'm back here.
There he is. Who's going to talk about some of the engineering aspects of the vehicle. Thank you.
Thanks, Clyde. Morning. Already been introduced. I'm Tony Brenders. I got to meet some of you over that small meal we had last night. I'm from the engineering team, and I get to talk to you today about some of the guts of this vehicle, some of the fun stuff we've been having over the last couple years, trying to get the right engineering stuff into this vehicle. And we set out to do the new Jeep Liberty. We really had three high-level objectives. You know, first and foremost, maintain that legendary Jeep capability. Absolutely critical to the Liberty and precious to the Jeep brand. Number two, better ride and handling. Everybody always wants better. We wanted better too. And number three, don't screw up the basic package. Add in all those great customer features that everybody's demanding these days. I think we did it. Maybe I'll tell you some more about that. Off-road capability. We got a great off-road track this afternoon at lunch. We got about five vehicles ready to go. Please go. I could stand here and talk to you all morning about capability. 30 minutes on the off-road course, you'd understand what I mean. So I'll let you do that. If you've never been off-road, don't be intimidated. We got lots of guys out there. I'll even go with you. I've managed to take the Rubicon through some pretty tough trails. The Rubicon. I went on the Rubicon with the Liberty 2 weeks ago. Took it through, made it all the way. Dented a few things, scratched a few things, but it made it all the way through because it's got that Jeep capability. I've had it out in Moab, Utah. Fantastic time out there. We really pretty proud of what we've been able to do in terms of maintaining that capability. In terms of overall ride and handling, the 2-inch longer wheelbase gives you a much better inherent ride. We added a 5-link rear suspension. It gives you more lateral stability, better cornering stiffness, and we softened up the shocks a little bit, so you get a more pleasant on-road kind of experience. A few lighter front-end components gives you a little bit quicker steering, a little bit of better on-center feel. I think when you're driving today on-road, you get a sense that the car is really, really tracked very well, goes where you point it, not a lot of nasty feedback, like bump steer or anything like that. So we're really happy with the way the ride and handling turned out. I think we met that objective. The other thing was don't screw it up. One of the things that our customer constantly told us was they loved the 3.7 power plant in this vehicle. 210 horsepower, 235 pound-feet of torque. Gives you great towing capability. We've got 5,000 pounds of towing capability, among the best in its class. So we're able to maintain a lot of that. Some great additional features, some of which you'll be able to try out today. Hill descent control also adds to the Jeep capability. The system where you put the vehicle in low range when you're going off-road, down in first gear, turn on the switch on the dash, and there'll be somebody out there to show you how to do all this. And the vehicle will walk down even the steepest hill at 2.5 miles per hour with your feet flat on the floor. You don't have to touch the brake, don't have to touch the gas. It truly brings the off-road capability right to the novice level, great for the experienced driver, something you'll be able to experience out there today. You can do it with and without. One of the other neat features is hill start assist, which in this nice flat Indiana ground that we get to drive on, you won't get much of a chance, so we'll try it out in the off-road. Think about driving in San Francisco, you know, some of those legendary, you know, pointing at the sky kind of streets. You're stopped at a stoplight. The only thing you see in your rear view mirror is this chrome Peterbilt sign about this big. This guy's right on your bumper. You want to launch off that stoplight, you don't really want to roll back into that guy. It might ruin your day. With hill start assist, you release the brake. The brakes continue to hold for about a second. Gives you enough time to get your foot on the gas. Pull away from the light like a rock star. Pretty cool feature. You'll be able to try it out in the off-road course because there are some hills out there. Just come to a stop and then get going again until you get time to transition. Mentioned the 5,000 pound towing capability. We also have trailer sway control. You ever get that sickening feeling towing a trailer where you start to if the trailer feels like it's driving the car. The thing you're supposed to do is speed up. Of course, it's the last thing you want to do. We've built into the electronic stability protection a program that monitors the vehicle direction, your steering direction, and the yaw of the vehicle, and the brakes will take care of that sway. So it's a great feature. Don't have any trailers out here today, but something we think our customers will really love. Some other features include standard electronic stability protection with electronic roll mitigation, and standard passenger and driver front airbags, side curtain airbags. Don't try those out. Trust me, they work great. We test them a lot. The other guys talked about some of the other really cool features on this vehicle, but probably the coolest feature is the sky slider roof. It's an industry exclusive to the Jeep Liberty. That roof will open all the way back over the C-pillar of the vehicle, so the driver and passenger are actually in the full open, right? It's like having a convertible in your SUV. Only one better, because you can open this one at speed. My favorite thing to do in the morning, I leave home, it's cold, I want to put the top down, like most convertible drivers. When I get out about an hour, sun comes out, I'm doing the speed limit, 70. And I open the roof up while I'm going by the guy in his convertible who also left home this morning with the top up, but has to pull over to put it down. I don't have to do that with this vehicle. As you can see, it not only opens full rearward, but forward as well. This is actually called the bikini mode, which is a holdover from the Wrangler days. I don't know if you remember seeing those Wranglers in the off-road where they just got a little top over the driver and the passenger. Did a lot of testing on it to make sure it was going to be great. Most important test was I sent it with my 16-year-old daughter to her cheerleading practice. We got a big cheer from the whole team as she showed up. So, pretty impressive kind of feature. Getting a lot of buzz from it. I think people are going to love it in terms of having something unique in the vehicle. So really, to sum up, I think we did it. You guys can tell me after you drive the off-road course, did we maintain the capability? Drive the on-road course, tell me, did we handle the ride and handling? I think we did. And then finally, play with the features. There's a ton of them. Some of the guys talked about some of the other ones. Some of you'd be lucky enough to drive the vehicle with a sky slider in it. Please enjoy yourself today. I'll be around all day. Ask me any questions. I'll be glad to answer them.